feelings get new. Love comes shining through. A million of stars unite, arising from your heart. A million of dreams will do come true. A million of stars unite, make everything alright. 'Cause all the
I'm not afraid to die. Hey! bar there, have a chat with them. Good luck out there.
Good luck, pal.
Hello. What's your name, please?
My name is Musa Wakwamota. I'm originally from South Africa, but I've recently moved to London.
Oh, you did? Fantastic. Tell me about you, please.
I got diagnosed with cancer when I was young. That's led to the amputation. And I was a football player before I got amputated. And then after my amputation, I fell in love with music. My friends, they were dancing at that time. I asked them to teach me how to dance. So they threw like boxes on the floor, and then they were like, okay, this is how you do it. Your left crotch, use it as a left leg. And then that's how it started. And then I'm in London, I'm in UK, I'm in my favorite country, England. This is the perfect time for me to actually reach out to more people and inspire a lot of people out there. And
That's incredible. So, how long have you spent preparing for this audition?
Since, I think, forever. I've been imagining myself on stage, and now it's happening, I'm like...
Yeah, I get it. Okay, well, look, no more questions.
Okay.
Good luck.
Thank you, I hope you enjoy.
Can you imagine what he's been through?
No. No.
The way I feel, I'm standing still. Nothing else matters now, you're not here. So where are you? I've been calling you, I'm missing you.
Sensational. Oh my God.
I've never seen anything like that. That was amazing.
Here I stand, taking off my crown and a run with nowhere to hide. I'm exposed, floating on. You're still here, and that's something beautiful.
That's a proper ovation, that.
Oh, that was brilliant.
That's something beautiful. Here with me.
Oh,
that's something beautiful.
That I think I've ever seen on this show. So much admiration for you, everything you've been through. You're clearly somebody, no matter what they put their mind to, you will achieve it. So well done.
That was exceptional. We all agree with that. Listen to me. We used them all. We used them all. Come. Please, please. If they do it again, they kill me. But no, they're going to kill me.
The word impossible into you. I am possible. I thank you so much.
You're an absolute hero.
What's your name?
My name is Courtney Gilmore.
Courtney Gilmore.
Yeah, I'm a stand-up comic. I'm from Toronto.
So why Canada's Got Talent?
As a person with a disability, it's really nice to have visible representation, and I personally didn't really have a lot of that when I was coming up in stand-up, and it would be nice if I were that person for someone else. So, yeah.
That's amazing.
Thank you.
It is amazing. Have a good time.
Thank you so much. I appreciate that. Thank you. Thank you so much, everyone, for having me. My name is Courtney. I am an Army amputee. I was born missing hands. No need to feel bad for me. I'm having a great no arms year. It's going really well, okay? Literally, no one is happier than me that we're done with handshakes, okay? Except maybe Howie. A lot of people My friends love to ask me, Courtney, don't you ever just wish that you had hands? And I have to be honest with you, no, I don't. I don't wish I had hands. I mostly just wish you guys didn't have hands. That would be, that'd be great for me. This is a team effort. Body image is a very important thing to me. Self-esteem, you know, you gotta be comfortable with who you are. I'm doing pretty well for myself, you know. Roll up the rim is a tough season, but that's fine. There are perks to being an amputee. For one example, I never have to get coffee for a bunch of people. Okay? I'm never the coffee run girl. You know, it's never me. 5 to 6 hot lattes in a tray, never seen it. Can I do it? Yeah. But who's gonna ask? Who looks worse? The guy who sends the girl with no hands out to get 8 large Americanos, or the barista who gives them to her? You know? Then I start asking for sleeves and it gets confusing.
That took me a second, but I got it.
I've had complete strangers come up to me and say, Courtney, you know, you're so brave. If I were you, I don't think I could do it. You know, if I were you, I think I would die. These are things that people say to me at a grocery store. Okay, I think I would die. I'm like, cool, I'm just trying to get mangoes, you know? And I say, yo, you know what? You wouldn't die. You would be absolutely fine. You would figure it out just like me. You would adapt to your surroundings. You would be good, you know? And then I see those same people spend 45 minutes at their self-checkout line trying to figure it out. And I'm like, you know what? You might die. You might die. I don't know. Thank you so much, everyone. Thank you.
Good closing.
Fantastic.
Hello, what's your name?
Hello, my name is Lee. And for obvious reasons, I'm also known as the Lost Voice Guy.
Okay, and how long have you lost your voice?
I just knew you were going to ask something that I hadn't thought about beforehand. So please excuse the awkward silence while I type out my answer. I've been speechless for 37 years.
Wow. Tell me why you decided to enter the show this year.
I think I entered Britain's Got Talent for the same reason everyone does. To meet Ant and Dec.
Yay! Really?
This is all going so well up until that point. The stage, Lee, is yours.
Hello, ladies and gentlemen. As you may be able to tell, I'm a struggling stand-up comedian who also struggles to stand up. To be honest, I'm not sure how good I am. I'll leave that for you to decide. But, just so you know, if you don't laugh at the disabled guy, you are going to hell. When I realized I'd never be able to talk again, I was speechless. I have lived in Newcastle all my life.
Yes!
But for some reason, I still haven't picked up the accent. I can see that some of you are trying to figure out where you know me from. Maybe it would help if I started saying phrases such as, the next train to arrive on platform 4 is the 12:52 service to London King's Cross. And, from my time at the post office, please go to cashier number 8. I got the train here today. I always like to sit in those seats for disabled people. I was about halfway here when another disabled person got on and asked me to move. I didn't realize I'd be playing disabled top trumps when I got on, or I would have dressed more special. Needless to say, I didn't give up my seat. Who cares if he was both blind and deaf? I was there first. It was very awkward. He couldn't see that I was still there. And I couldn't tell him I wasn't moving because I can't speak. Before I leave you, I have one more thing to say. I hate that we have so many, politically, correct words to describe disabled people now. It's all special needs, special schools, special Olympics. I don't know what is so special about me. That is why it always alarms me when I hear about special forces going to war. You've been a fantastic audience. Goodbye.
Bloody brilliant.
No, that's a dance call,
but you know, romantically linked.
No.
All right.
He stood right there.
Good luck.
Have fun out there.
Good evening.
What's your names?
I'm Gary.
I'm Paula.
And we're Strictly Wheels.
Strictly Wheels?
Yes.
What's your relationship?
We're really good friends. We've been friends together for about 10 years.
Just friends?
Just friends.
And do you think that you've got an act that's going to blow us away today?
Hopefully. It's something that you probably haven't seen before, so yeah.
All right, well, I wish you the best of luck. The stage is yours.
Been a negative into a positive, and you did things that two dancers don't normally do. It was absolutely fantastic.
Very good.
Amanda, how you dance, your control of that chair and your muscle in your arm is unbelievable. You were fantastic, the pair of you.
I thought it was going to be a bit uncomfortable, you know, like quite slow. And then suddenly, Paula kicks off. You are much better than Gary, by the way.
But very good, and I think you're fun. I like you two.
Yeah, Gary and Paula, you've got such a great connection. That was beautiful to watch. Surprising, refreshing, unique. The guys have said it all, so I think we should put this to a vote. David.
I loved you. It's a yes.
Yes.
It's a yes from me as well.
It's a brilliant, positive, fabulous yes from me. Well done.
Simon.
You've got four yeses. Congratulations.
Well, four yeses, no buzzers, through the next round. Must be pleased with that.
Yeah.
Yeah.
That was clever.
We've seen her all this year, haven't we?
Here we go. That's the audience. They're a lovely bunch. You like them a lot.
Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Britain's Got Talent.
Thank you.
What's your name?
My name is Serene.
How old are you?
I'm 14.
14?
Yes.
And whereabouts are you from?
I'm from London.
Okay. Have you told your friends at school you're here today?
No, they have no idea I'm here.
Right, okay. So who's here with you today?
My grandfather, my two aunties, my uncle, my cousin, my brother, and my parents.
A nice mix.
It's me. It's the entire audience.
It is the entire audience.
Yes.
I like that. Is there anything else you want to tell us about you, yourself?
So I guess it's pretty obvious that I can't see. There was a time where I could, and now I can't. But I guess music is my vision, and that's just what I live by, and music is my thing.
Good for you. Well, we're all rooting for you, and I know everyone at home is going to be rooting for you too. So, in your own time, Serene.
Thank you.
Alan's here.
Yes.
That was good. Well done. Okay. There you are. There you go. There you go. Good luck, Serene. Oh, dear, crazy.
Thank you.
Best of luck. You sound great.
Well done, Serene. What you couldn't see was the whole of the Palladium on their feet applauding you because they love you. Alicia.
Oh, what a sweet, sweet girl you are. My heart is just melted.
Thank you.
You're so nervous, but that's completely understandable. It's a massive deal, it's a massive stage, and you sang beautifully.
I just found the entire audition so poignant. You're just so beautiful and vivacious. You kind of just exude lightness.
Oh my gosh,
it was,
thank you.
It was just brilliant.
Thank you.
Serene, were you nervous because you thought you were going to get bad comments? Have people criticised you in the past?
I only do school performances, so this is something completely new. And being able to sing right now is just such a big opportunity, and I don't want to waste it.
Good for you. I think I should be the first person to say yes.
It's a yes from me.
It's a yes from me.
And it's a yes from me. Well done, Serene. Yes. Well, I could hope.
That was really good. Absolutely fantastic.
Hi.
Hello.
Hello.
Okay. Tom.
Hello.
Hello, Alicia.
How are you, my darling?
Dirty. You look nice.
You look fabulous. We have met before, haven't we?
Yes.
Alicia invited us to come and audition today, didn't
yes.
she?
Yes! So, for everybody here, tell us a bit about yourselves and what you're going to be doing and why.
Well, for Nathan, this is such a special moment to get to perform for everybody and show that you really have a passion for something, then you can achieve really great things. As you can see, he's got a wonderfully cheeky personality and just thrives on dancing. And we are very excited because today we're going to perform Nathan's favourite dance, which is the...
Cha-cha-cha!
Oh, we yes. love a cha-cha-cha!
For you, Bruno.
Oh, for me, my darling. Oh.
Yeah, darling. And all please stand up, say shouting, slapping, and tear. Come on.
Well, whenever you're ready, good luck.
Yeah.
I messed up tonight. I lost another fight.
It was a cheeky, sizzling, joyous cha-cha-cha. You've given me that. You've given me the shape. You were working it, honey. Keep doing it.
Made it day.
Amanda?
I feel so proud of you. Your footwork was brilliant. Your facial expressions were everything. You were just amazing.
We do get good dancers who are very boring on this show. But both of you have got such amazing personality. Even before you started, I think every single person in this theatre was just going, just be brilliant. And you were brilliant. And everything about this audition, I've got to tell you, I love.
Oh, Joanne, thank you so much for nominating Nathan. Nathan, thank you for being such a superstar today and making us all feel joy. You've really moved me. Thank you.
Can I be the first to say yes, please?
Thinking to yourselves here, well, if this guy's blind, why is he wearing glasses then?
I didn't even think that, actually. I didn't even think about it.
Just take you down the side of stage.
There's a bit of tape here, mind.
Strange camera. This isn't
it. You got it?
Right.
All right, straight ahead for now.
Here we go. Here we are, centre stage.
And then
take your board. There you are.
There you go, you got it?
There's your mic. You got it? Enjoy.
OK, good luck, pal.
Hello.
Hello.
How are you?
Yeah, I'm excited to be here.
Take it you are from Scotland?
Yes.
Whereabouts in Scotland?
I'm from a small town just outside Glasgow.
Lovely. Very nice. What's your name?
My name is Cubby.
Cubby, that's a cool name.
That's my actual name's terrible. It wouldn't work on stage.
Oh, please tell me, please. What's your real name?
David Cuthbertson.
That's cool. David
Cuthbertson.
Cubby works better.
Cubby's cool. And can you tell me a little bit about yourself?
Well, I'm actually a blind comic. And I've had a degenerative eye condition since birth.
Right.
And gradually things have just got worse over the years until now where I could basically see some bright lights.
Right, okay. And how long have you been doing comedy?
About 5 years, because as my eyesight kind of got worse, your passions are taken away from you. But I think I've found something that my eyesight won't be a problem anymore. I've never let it get me down. I just want to... Don't take it seriously.
Good luck, my love.
Good evening, Britain's Got Talent. Very excited to be here, especially after I was told that I'd be led on stage by two absolute professionals and legends of the show.
Thank you.
Sadly, though, Stavros Flatley weren't available tonight. And I know the first thing you're probably thinking to yourselves here, well, if this guy's blind, why is he wearing glasses then?
I didn't even think that, actually. I didn't even think about it.
Why is he?
I've got to say, this gig's already going better than my last one. I was 5 minutes into that before someone told me I was still standing in the middle of the train station. And believe it or not, folks, but I do have a long-term girlfriend. Yeah, won't catch me in the undateables, eh? But it is hard meeting women when you're blind, you know. Very few seem to want a real blind date. It'll probably come as no surprise to anyone that I've got a dog, eh? No. Might surprise you to learn, though, that it's a Bichon Frise. Have you seen them?
Yes.
I haven't. Oh, and you're not going to believe this, but my bleeding dogs went blind on me. What are the chances? Quite high as it happens when your dog's a diabetic. He still manages to hone in on food, though, like a wee blind diabetic sugar ninja, though. But taking him for a walk now is a right barrel of laughs, I'll tell you. The blind are leading the blind here, people. Ladies and gentlemen, Britain's Got Talent, you've been absolutely awesome. Thanks very much for listening. I've been Cubby.
What did you think? I honestly think you have real potential, and I'm honoured that you came on the show because you did brilliantly.
Thanks
so well
very
done.
Much.
David?
Your stories were fantastic. They were authentic. They were true to you. You've turned what might be a negative in your life into a positive, and I'm so pleased you came on the show. And the only way to judge comedy is it funny? Yeah, it was hilarious. So well done, you.
Thanks, David.
Okay. Simon?
You are really, really, really funny, Cubby. And you know what I love? What really made me laugh was that you were laughing at your own jokes. And that always cracks me up because I do the same thing when... Normally, in my case, no one else finds me funny apart from myself, but I do have a habit of doing it. We're really lucky that you came on the show this year.
Well, Cubby, I completely agree with my fellow judges. I think you're such a nice guy. It was very authentic. You've got naturally funny bones. And I think you're going to inspire a lot of people. And I think people are going to really, really root for you. So I am going to kick this off with a yes. David.
Cubby, I'm saying yes.
It's a yes from me.
And now you have four yeses, Cubby.
Well done, Cubby.
Let's grab that mic off here.
There you are.
Do you want to say one more thing?
Thanks very much.
Got it.
You got me? Straight ahead. Well done.
Were they standing at them?
Yeah, they were. You had a standing ovation. Yeah, of course you can't see.
You had a standing ovation and typically I missed that.
Standing ovation from the audience and from all four judges. We probably...
Hello. Please introduce yourselves.
So I'm Jade, and what's your name? Christian. Christian is my little brother, and we're sign along with us.
How old are you?
I'm 18 years old. And how old are you, Christian?
Four.
He's four.
Oh, yeah. My goodness me. Fantastic. What are you going to do for us today?
So we're here to do some sign language and some singing.
Brilliant.
Thank you. We were told that Christian would never be able to communicate. I taught him sign language so then he could talk. And he's here, a little miracle, proving everybody wrong.
Yes, sister! That's what she's supposed to do.
We wish you all the best.
Say thank you.
Don't make me melt.
To be ashamed of all my scars.
long. Whoa.
That song is such an anthem for people who maybe don't feel part of the world or part of anything. And I just found it really, really moving.
Thank you.
It was absolutely brilliant.
Hello, thank you.
Gla-gla.
Thank you.
I genuinely can't find the words.
Amazing!
There you go.
Thank you!
And Christian, you are an absolute little star, so thank you.
Hey, thank you.
Gaga!
I have to confess, I have a friend of mine in this choir. Ella. We met at the Pride of Britain, and I heard Ella sing, and I said, I have a feeling one day you're going to be auditioning on one of our shows, and guess what? You're here. And you'd say, this is me, and I'm thinking, you are us, because you define what this show should be all about. This is an audition I will never, ever forget.
Thank you.
I
promise you I'll keep
you safe. Every one of you gave everything to this performance, an amazing positive message to put out there, and all I can say is...
Amazing, amazing, amazing. Well done. Well done.